I don't know if it was a mistake at that time, because remember, the root causes of these flows, migration flows, have become much more serious, because we see that in more countries are there problems with poverty, or there is war or conflict going on. So I just think that we see an increased pressure and an increased flow of migrants.
Because at the time, Britain even said, well, let's not fund a search and rescue operation because, in fact, it would be encouraging migrants to make the journey. They were wrong. Other European countries were wrong as well, because the numbers are up and the number of dead is rising as well.
Yeah, but we can, of course, keep on discussing whose fault it was. But I think now we have an acute situation and really a sense of urgency that we have to exploit in order to get good concrete measures going. So what we have discussed today is everything from fighting the trafficking and the illegal activities of the ruthless people who send these poor people in unsecured boats, to how to maybe even destroy ships that have been used for this, to discussing resettlement arrangements, to police and security cooperation, and how to address these politically, the root causes, for example, the situation in Libya.
Right. Amnesty International, essentially, when Mare Nostrum ended and this very limited program called Triton was started at the EU level, said history will judge our failure as unforgivable when it comes to these migrants. Do you agree?
Yeah, I think it is unforgivable that we have let so many people die already in the Mediterranean, to drown in the Mediterranean. Not only did they lose their hope for a future in the European Union, but 1,500 have already lost their lives. That's unforgivable, and we have to make better. And we just have to discuss the long list of proposals that the Commission has come up with, and we have to add, all member states have to add their ideas and also their willingness and their concrete actions now to make sure that we implement those lists.